you know, I don't know how you can believe in a God who wants to condemn most of the planet, you know, to a fiery hell. Like, what type of loving, sensitive, omnipresent, omnipotent being wants to condemn most of his beautiful creation to a fiery hell?
Well, what I think he's saying there, what kind of God would wants to condemn all of his creation to hell? What kind of loving God? This is one of the great errors of modern theology, is that everybody's putting all their chips on the love of God, and they forgot about the holiness of God. What kind of loving God wants to send all his creation to hell? That's not even the right question. The right question is, what kind of holy God would ever let anybody go to heaven? That's the right question. And so he's only seeing his righteousness. Aaron Rodgers in his video is projecting a severe amount of self-righteousness. What kind of loving God wants to send everybody to hell? Well, that's not you're asking the wrong questions, Aaron. You're asking the question of a loving God, when the truth is you need to be thinking in your mind about a holy God. A holy God who gave 10 commandments and you've broken every one of them. A holy God that you have offended with your wickedness. A holy God that you have trampled over the blood of his son that he willingly gave for you so you could die, so you could have the forgiveness of sin. A God who gave his only begotten son who died on the cross for you, was buried, and rose again 3 days later. You've rejected that holy God and his son. And so that's the kind of God you're dealing with. You have offended him. You've rejected his offer. And because of that, yes, a person who rejects that will die and go to hell without Christ. And you won't be able to say, you didn't love me. You didn't love me, God, because God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. That's John 3:16. The loving God that would condemn all of his creation is a loving God that sent his only begotten son to die for you, and all you had to do is receive him as your savior, but you didn't. You turned your back on that. You got a smug self-righteousness about you. You denied Christ. You denied his church. You walked away from all that thinking, well, what kind of loving God could send somebody like me to hell? That's a terrible thing to say. Aaron Rodgers is in serious spiritual danger here if he doesn't realize the truth that he is not the self-righteous man he is. He is a wicked sinner. He's going to die and go to hell without Christ if he doesn't repent of his sins and trust Jesus. So in conclusion here, Aaron Rodgers is playing the game of self-righteousness. He thinks that he doesn't deserve to die and go to hell, but also he's showing the fruitation of the evidence of neo-evangelicalism being a witness to him. Okay, he had the Christian rock. He had all the Christian fun. He had all the youth stuff and all the cool, hip, rad youth pastor and all that. He had all that, and now he's, you know, almost 40 years old, and he's a lost heathen man dying and going to hell, rejecting Christ. He didn't get a thimble full of the gospel message in his early years growing up and that stuff. And really, that's the problem with evangelicalism, Johnny, is that it exalts fun and coolness and hipness over Bible truth, and it tries to make all of that cool and nice, but it actually waters it down so much that you really don't get any. Hey guys, subscribe to our channel. We're going to do many more videos like this, talking about all kinds of things like this, and we'd love for you to subscribe and be a part of our YouTube family. Thank you so much, and have a good day. God bless you.